Yeah. Hi everyone, my name is Ravi Prakash and this is the 6th class of Factorials. Okay, we are into number system part 3. So in this we'll discuss first concept is numbers which are sum of factorials of their digits. Okay, which numbers are there which are sum of factorials of their digits, right? For example, one is equal to one factorial, of course. So sum of factorials is only one digit here. So one is one. Similarly, two is two factorial only, right? But after this, you'll get the number as one for third number as 145. What is 145? Sum of one factorial plus four factorial plus five factorial. Okay, the sum of one factorial plus four factorial plus five factorial, right? So this is the third such number, first number, second number, third number. Okay, numbers which are sum of factorials of their digits, right? So what is 145? 1 factorial is 1, 4 factorial is 24, and what is 5 factorial? 120. So 120 plus 24 plus 1 will give you what? 145, right? So sometimes questions are asked like this, right? So you can remember it. Okay, and one more number is there. That is 40585, okay, which is equal to 4 factorial plus 0 factorial plus 5 factorial plus 8 factorial plus 5 factorial. Okay, so 40585 is a number which is in which number is the sum of factorials of the digit, right? What is 8 factorial? 40,320 plus 120, that is 5 factorial plus 120. Plus 1, that is 0 factorial, plus 24. If you add all this, you will get result as what? 40585. Okay. So, there can be many questions on this concept, right? So, we'll discuss one. This question can be, if A factorial plus B factorial plus C factorial is equal to ABC, okay, where ABC, where ABC is a 3-digit number, then find the highest power of 7, highest power of 7 in ABC factorial. Okay, this is a question, right? So you can frame questions like this. So if A factorial plus B factorial plus C factorial is equal to ABC, where ABC is a 3-digit number, then find the highest power of 7 in ABC factorial, right? So there are only 4 number in mathematics in which sum of factorials of their digits is equal to the number itself. Okay, there are only 4 numbers. What are the numbers? We discussed in last slide. 1, 2, 145 and 40585. There exist only 4 number in whole mathematics, right? You can easily remember these 4 numbers, right? It will save a lot of your time. Instead of trying hit and trial, trying to find the number, right? You can do. Okay. So ABC is a 3-digit number. So find the highest power of 7 in ABC factorial. So now right now we know that for 3-digit number, only one such number exists. That is 145, where 145 equal to 1 factorial plus 4 factorial plus 5 factorial. Fine. What I need to find? I need to find the highest power of 7. So I need to find the highest power of 7 in 145 factorial. This is the question. Okay. So you can find highest power of 7 in 145 factorial. Same funda. Okay. 7 goes 19 times. 19, 7 is 133. Now 7 will go 2 times. What is the answer? 21. Therefore, highest power of 7 in 145 factorial is what? 21. So 21 is the answer. Okay, yeah, fine. Okay, next concept. Okay, see, you got to remember this concept also, right? This will be very useful in few cases. You may not be direct question, less possibility that direct questions can be asked from this concept, right? But it can be used in eliminating options also, right? So you should know this concept basically. Now this concept is, if n factorial has n digits, then n is equal to 1, 22, 23, 24. If n factorial has n digits, then n has got only 4 such possible values, 1, 22, 23, 24, right? Means if you calculate the value of 22 factorial, let's say whatever is the value, there will be in total 22 digits here. Okay, similarly, calculate the value of 24 factorial, there will be 24 digits here. So these results are derived from higher mathematics, which we can use smartly in our aptitude examination to save a lot of time, right? So you should remember this, right? Just trust me, remember all these concepts. Single question outside this concept cannot be asked in any of the examination, right? In next so many years, right? So just get all these concepts from 10 and 15 books and from 10 and 15 kinds of material are combined into single video course, right? So just note it down, practice it. This is absolutely enough for any of your examination, right? Okay, so if n factorial has n digits, then n is equal to 1, 22, 23, 24. So only 4 such values are possible. Okay, now next one. If n factorial has less than n digits, then n will lie somewhere in between 21 to 2. Right, so for 1, 22, 23 and 24, n factorial has n digits, exactly. N factorial has n digits, exactly. Like 1 factorial has 1 digit, 22 factorial value has got 24 digits. So n factorial has got n digits. So in this case, if n factorial has less than n digits, okay, so n is between 2 and 21. Like suppose 5 factorial is 120, right? So n factorial has less than n digits. So here there are 3 digits, here there are 1 digit only, right? So n factorial has less than n digit. 4 factorial is 24. So here, like, n factorial has less than n digits, okay? So 4 factorial has less than 4 digits. 5 factorial has less than 5 digits, right? Sorry, not 3 I should write here. Sorry, 5. Now, n factorial has less than n digits. So 5 factorial has less than 5 digits. 4 factorial has less than 4 digits. For all these numbers, which numbers? From between 2 and 21. Okay. And third one, if n factorial has more than n digits, then n will be greater than equal to what? 25. Okay, n is greater than equal to 25, and also n is equal to 0. Also true for n equal to 0, right? So if n factorial has more than n digits, right? So why 0? You can understand it, right? Because 0 factorial has, what is the value of 0 factorial? 1. So n 0 factorial has more than 0 digits, obviously, because 0 factorial is 1 and it is more than 0 digit, right? So 0 factorial is equal to 1, right? So for all such numbers, n greater than equal to 25 and n equal to 0, n factorial has more than n digits. Okay, so 3 very good concepts, kindly note it down and remember it, right? Okay, we'll do a problem on this. We write the question here. Now, question is, if n factorial has n digits, then there would be how many zeros at the end of factorial of sum of all such values of n. Sum of all such values of n. Okay, so this is a question. The question is, if n factorial has n digits, then there would be how many zeros at the end of factorial of sum of all such values of n, right? So, okay. So, first thing, n factorial has n digits. Now, we know that n factorial has n digits for n is equal to 1, 22, 23 and 24. N factorial has exactly n digits for which four numbers? N equal to 1, 22, 23 and 24. Right. So what is sum of all such n? Sum of all such n is equal to 1 plus 22 plus 23 plus 24. This is equal to what? This is equal to 70. Okay, so you need to find the number of zeros. So what is the quadratic question? Find there will be how many zeros at the end of factorial of sum of all such values of n. So required to find, so hence we are in this question, we are required to find number of trailing zeros in 70 factorial. That we can easily find, right? Because number of trailing zeros is equal to what? Is equal to number of fives. Number of fives, right? So how many fives is 70 factorial? How many fives is 70 factorial? Do it mentally. 5 divides 70 14 times. 5 divides 14 2 times, right? So 14 plus 2 16. Simply 5 divides 70 14 times. 5 divides 14 2 times. 14 plus 2 16. Okay. So in 70 factorial, it is 5 raised to 16. Therefore, 16 trailing zeros. This is the answer in 70 factorial, right? So this is a very good question, right? Somehow you get this concept. These are very tough concepts. If you get these questions in mind, these concepts in mind, right? You'll feel very confident. You'll feel very confident, right? Because you have to, when you finish this, all these videos, right? You know that you have got everything in your mind. All the concepts you have in your mind, right? Nothing is missed, absolutely, right? 200% everything is covered. From where a toughest question can be asked in any aptitude examination, all are been covered here, right? Okay, so we'll do some good questions also, right? Next concept, we'll do some good questions. The next question is, how many two-digit numbers are there in which product of factorials of its digits is greater than sum of factorials of its digits, right? So again, a very good question, right? It's a very, very good question. You need to sit back, relax, and try this question for at least 10 minutes, right? Find some pattern, because these are the questions which will really, really raise your intelligence level, right? You try to find some pattern. You try to play with the numbers, 10, 20, 30, what is happening, in which it is true, right? Your mind really opens up for tougher questions, right? This is aptitude, right? So this question, you should spend some time, at least 10 minutes, right? So pause this video here itself and spend some 10 minutes on it at least, right? Okay, so we'll solve now. See, the question is, how many two-digit numbers are there in which product of factorials of its digits is greater than sum of factorials of its digits, right? So let's say a two-digit number is AB. So what is the condition? That product of factorials of its digits, right? That is A factorial into B factorial should be greater than sum of factorials of its digits, right? That is A factorial plus B factorial. Okay, it's fine, right? Right now you could sense nothing. Maybe you are thinking nothing. What is it? You must be thinking, what is the question, right? What is the concept? But okay, try it. Put some numbers here. See some pattern, right? So it's about two-digit numbers, right? So I know the answer is obviously from 10 to 99. Obviously from 10 to 99, right? So let's start with 10. What happens? Does 10 satisfy? Let's check. So for 10, 1 factorial into 0 factorial should be greater than 1 factorial plus 0 factorial, right? What is it? It is 1 factorial is 1, 0 factorial is 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. So 1 is not greater than 2, right? So for 10, it is not satisfying. Okay, fine. Come next. Let's put some 20 here. Okay. 20 factorial, 2 factorial into 0 factorial should be greater than 2 factorial plus 0 factorial, right? See, again, 2 into 1 is 2. And here 2 plus 1 is 3. For 20, it is also not satisfying, right? Now, why it is not? So you'll get this idea straight away that whenever a number contains a 0, right, it would not satisfy, because when 0 factorial is multiplied in left side, when 0 factorial is multiplied in left side, so 0 factorial is 1. 0 factorial is 1. So it will be always into 1, something into 1, like 2 factorial into 1. Where in right side, it will be right, 0 factorial is added. So it is like 2 factorial plus 1. So always right side would be greater. Always right side would be greater, right? But what I want left hand side to be greater. The first very good idea you got, that number should not contain 0, right? That means it is not true for all the numbers like 10, 20, 30 till 90. First idea, right? So this idea will get when you put your pen on paper, my dear, right? Try solving it. Okay. Now, second, let's, after 10, let's check for, so let's say some number 11. What is for 11? So 11 factorial, again, for 11 factorial, 1 factorial into 1 factorial is greater than 1 factorial plus 1 factorial. See, again, it is not true, right? Again, a second idea you should get here is, whenever a digit contains 1, whenever a digit contains 1, on left side, it will be something into 1 factorial. And on the right side, it will be that same something plus 1 factorial. Right? That is, this part is same, right? Because A factorial here is same. A factorial and A factorial is same here, right? So if B factorial is equal to 1, so if this B factorial is equal to, let me write here, if this B factorial is equal to 1, then A factorial into 1 is A factorial only. Where it becomes right side what? It becomes A factorial plus 1 factorial. So obviously right side would be greater in this case, right? So that means digit should not contain 1, right? Digit should not contain 1. Take example, right? Take another example, no issue. If you didn't understand this, take another example. Take 31 factorial. What will happen? 3 factorial into 1 factorial should be greater than 3 factorial plus 1 factorial, right? Not true. Why not true? Same thing which I was explaining earlier, right? This 3 factorial and 3 factorial will be same, right? So whenever there is a 1 here, so here 1 is multiplied and here 1 is added. So this 3 being same, when 1 is multiplied, will always be less than when 1 is added, right? So I want this to be greater. That means this again would be not possible. The second idea you got is, okay, that number should not contain any digit 1. So like 11 to 19 I can't take, or numbers like 21, 31, 41 till 91 I can't take, because all this contains one, right? So when you scrutinize like this very small, very finely, so you'll get this answer as total. So let's write right now total values, right? What are the total values? So total values will be, how much? There are how many 2-digit numbers? There are 90 2-digit numbers, right? There are 90 2-digit numbers. So out of 90 2-digit numbers, I can't take those numbers that are from, basically, you see, it will come from 10 to 22, right? Because 22 also you can't take, because in 22, 2 plus 2 is also 4, 2 into 2 is also 4. Right now it is not same for 33, because in 33, 3 into 3 is 9 and 3 plus 3 is 6. So if digits are same, their multiplication and addition is same only in case of 22, right? So like for 22 factorial, it will be like 2 factorial into 2 factorial will be greater than 2 factorial plus 2 factorial, right? Which is not possible, right? This is 4 and 4. 4 is not greater than 4. It's not true, right? So that's what I'm telling, 10 to 22. Right, so minus what I'm writing here, 90 numbers minus those 13 numbers from 10 to 22, minus all those numbers containing 1, Right, other than this. So what are left? Like minus how many numbers? From 31 to 91, there are 7 numbers. From 31 to 91, there are 7 numbers. Right. So 31 to 90. I've written all those numbers containing 1, right? So from 31 to 91, because 11 and 21 are included here itself. Okay. And then further minus all the numbers containing zeros, right? So 10 and 20 are already subtracted here. So what we need to further minus? From 30 to 90. So another 7 numbers. So another 7 numbers from 30, like 30 to 90. So 30, 40 till 90. Right. Here also I can write a little bit in detail. I can write here. Okay. So like 31, 41 till 91. Okay. So 7 numbers here, 7 numbers here, 30 numbers here. So what is the final answer? 90 minus 13 minus 7 minus 7. So your answer is 63. Right. This is a super question. This is a super question, right? An absolutely beautiful question to open up your mind. So this kind of question you should try and give some time to solve. Okay, give some time to solve for this kind of question, right? Okay, so you spend some 5 minutes. When you've understood also, right? Do some mathematics on your paper and pen. Try for at least 5 minutes this question, right? After I explained also this, right, this question. Answer is what? Answer is 63 for this question, okay? Okay, next question. The next question will be, how many two digit number exceeds the sum of, can you please write, exceeds the sum of factorials of their digits. This is a question, right? So how many two digit numbers exceeds the sum of factorials of their digits, right? Again, a super question, right? So we're doing very good questions here. Some very good concepts are being covered, right? Please pay attention. Watch these videos multiple times, right? These questions you won't get in a single book or in a single course, right? These have been collected from multiple sources, right? And some framed by me also, because I have framed many questions in career launcher mock tests and IMS mock tests, like. So I used to frame many LRDI sets and quant sets, right? So very, very great questions, right? I'm discussing here. Okay, so again, same thing. Pause this video for 5-10 minutes. Try it by your heart, right? And then again switch on. Then I will solve. Okay, right now I'm solving. So how many two digit numbers exceeds the sum of the factorials of their digits, right? That means how many two digit numbers like AB exceeds, that means it should be greater than sum of factorials of their digits, right? So straight away you should get an idea that AB is a two digit number. So factorial also can't be a three-digit number, right? So any factorial greater than five, we can't take, right? Why? Because 5 factorial is 120. 5 factorial is 120, okay? So 120 is a three-digit number, three-digit number, right? So if 3-digit number will come on right side, if any 3-digit number will come on right side, it can never be greater than a 2-digit number, right? That's why any factorial greater than 5 we can't take. That means, that automatically means that a b value cannot be greater than equal to 5, right? Cannot be greater than equal to 5. So a and b value cannot take 5 at all, right? So A and B value cannot take 5 at all. Okay. So what we are left with now? So we are left with, right? What we are left with now? So we are left with, obviously, which numbers I should take? So it's about 2-digit numbers. So I should take all the numbers from 10 to 14, I should take at first. correct? Right, because I don't have to take any number. Any digit cannot be greater than 5. So I can't take 15, 16 and all, right? Because it contains a digit as 5, right? Then 20 to 24 I can take. Then 30 to 34 I can take. Then 40 to 44 I can take, right? That's it. That's it, right? So 5 numbers here, 5 numbers here, 5 here, 5 here. Total 20 numbers, but wait, this is not the answer. Total 20 numbers I am concerned with, right? Total 20 numbers I am concerned with, but let's check now another, we check with 14, right? I am checking with that AB should be greater than A factorial plus B factorial. Let's check that for 14. If you check 14, so if you check for 14, see what happens. So 14 is greater than 1 factorial plus 4 factorial, right? Is it true? No, it is not true. It is not true. 14 is not greater than this, right? So again, why are you checking at 14? Because again, 4 is a bigger number, right? 4 is a bit big number. 5 factorial, absolutely I can't take, right? But 4 factorial also is a big number when compared to this 1 factorial and 2 factorial, right? That's why I'm checking at 14. That means I have to check all the digits at, all the digits containing 4, I need to again check. I need to again check for all the digits containing 4, right? For 14, it is not true, okay? Then for 24, is it true? For 24, 2 factorial plus 4 factorial. Again, 4 factorial is 24, right? So 24, you can sense it, right? 4 factorial, why I'm checking at 24? Why I'm checking at 14? Because 4 factorial is 24. So it, this left side should be greater than 24, obviously, right? So which is not true in case of 14 and 24. Okay, now is it true for, let's say, is it true for 34? So 34 is greater than 3 factorial plus 4 factorial. So 24 plus 6, 30. Yeah, it is greater, correct, no issue. 44, 44 is greater than 4 factorial plus 4 factorial? No, 4 factorial plus 4 factorial is what, 48. 44 is not greater than that, so not possible, right? So out of those 20 numbers, subtract further 3. Subtract further 3. So 17 would be the answer, right? Now you can check. There are no other such possibilities, right? Because now, why? Because now we won't check for 13 factorial. Because why we won't check for 13 factorial? Because 13 factorial will be greater than 1 factorial plus 3 factorial. Because 3 factorial is only 6. It's a single digit number. So even if we're adding 1 factorial, 2 factorial in it, it is like not reaching to 2 digit also, right? That's why all 2 digit number will be greater than 1 factorial plus 3 factorial or 2 factorial plus 3 factorial, like that, right? So our answer is 20 minus 3, 17. Another super question, right? These are very good question. Please concentrate, practice, understand, okay? And ping me in case of any doubt, okay? We have a doubt forum also. So please ping me in case of any doubt, okay? Thank you for watching this video.